You can never be called a chordate without three things that cannot be ignored. A complex dorsal hollow nervous system, gill slits, and a notochord. A complex dorsal hollow nervous system, that's the brain and a spinal cord, in fact. Hollow means there's space in the center, and a dorsal means it's closer to the back. Every chordate, big or little, has one, though some may be considered rather small. But from a lamprey to a lizard to a lemur, it controls their actions one and all. The gill slits are paired openings in the throat. Sometimes they're called the pharyngeal clefts. Inside them, gills develop in the fishes, as well as in aquatic forms of efts. And everyone here knows what an eft is, right? Right, that's right, it's the adult form of a newt. You know, one of those pudgy, slimy, southern salamanders. However, in land-dwelling chordates, as they grow in egg or uterus, the embryonic gill slits disappear, leaving a tube of eustachius. The notochord's an embryonic structure, a semi-rigid, flexible, tough rod. No insect, starfish, worm, or snail has one, but they're in each embryonic cat and cod. Invertebrates, the backbone forms around it, as they develop past the embryo, and early in development it causes the nervous system to begin to grow. And I'm a chordate because I've got a dorsal hollow nervous system, all my thoughts and movements to control, and I had gill slits in my tiny throat years ago when I was an embryo. Have another characteristic that you should remember from before, that defining feature of all chordates. I had an embryonic notochord, and I'm a chordate. That's right, I'm a chordate, 'cause I had a notochord.